We're going to talk now about position vectors. So position vectors are basically a vector that tells you how to get from one place to another. Not too complicated, right? Or it shouldn't be, at least. So let's say we've got some point out here in space. Point, I don't know, A, to be super creative about it. So we have some point A at 3, 2. Now it shouldn't take too much of a stretch to say, okay, well, I can draw a vector to that position. And I can call that vector RA. Now, if I wanted to write that in I hat J hat notation, I could say that's a 3 I hat plus 2 J hat position vector, right? Not too crazy. So these are all position vectors. I can do something different. I could go back to, and I could go up one, and I could call that point B at negative 2, 1. And then if I wanted to draw in the position vector from the origin, maybe I should be more specific about that. The position vector from the origin would be, where can I put it? RB would be negative 2 I hat plus 1 J hat. But rather than, of course, saying 1 J hat, we could just say plus J hat. Okay? So that's point B. Okay, so there's that. Now what we can do is we can create a vector that goes from A to B. From A to B. A to B. And the notation that we'll use for this is to say R from A to B. Now I can count, and I can say, okay, it's going to go back 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's going to go back 5, and it's going to go down 1. Just by counting the blocks or whatever. But there's a better way to do this, because this would be very, very annoying, and even, yeah, it's going to get bad, especially if we go into 3D. So what we want to do is create a general formula that we can use to correlate position vectors and position from one to the other. So let's take a look and think about this as being the triangle rule. So I could say, well, I start here, and I go here, and then I go here, so my resultant is this guy, right? You see that as the triangle rule? So let's say I do this, and then I do this, so here's my resultant, okay? Blah, blah, resultant. This should be reasonably straightforward at this point for you. So I'm going to say I'm going to go RA, and then I'm going to go A to B, and that should give me my resultant there. Make sense? So if I want to know, well, how would I find this position vector in general, I can just solve for it by subtracting RA from both sides. Oops. Okay. Now, I actually thoroughly recommend that you remember how to derive this little formula than try and memorize it, because every time I've tried to memorize this, I always memorize it backwards, and then my A's and the B's are in the wrong place and stuff like that. So I strongly recommend just actually learning it. Wow, crazy. Then memorizing it, because memorization is only sometimes useful. Some things you're good at memorize, but I wouldn't call this one of them. And that's mainly because I can't seem to figure it out. So again, you wanna, if you're trying to think about how this works, draw yourself, and if you're on a test, like, oh man, I forgot the order. Don't worry about the order. Just say, if I start here and I go from here to here, there's my resultant. So if I start at the origin, if I go to A, and then I go from A to B, I end up at B. And to me, this makes a lot more sense to memorize it this way than to try to memorize it that way. And again, not really memorize, I'm just talking my way through it. Okay? So that's your justification, or this way for position vectors. And if you want to go check, you can see that if we use this formula here, we get the value for RAB above. We would get RAB is equal to, I'm going to go ahead and write it down like this. Minus 3 I hat plus 2 J hat. And that gives me, I'm actually working it all out. Good for me. Blah, 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 blah. Minus 5 I hat. Except I can't distribute the negative because I'm apparently incapable of basic algebra. There we go. Good? Okay. So And this works in 3D as well. This is just a good little refresher on position vectors and how they work. What's also important to note is that this works in reverse. So I could also say, well, if I start at B and I go from B to A, I end up at A, right? Would that make sense? If I start at B and I go from B to A, then my resultant is I end up at A. This is apparently B, this is apparently A in my little imagination. So it works in reverse as well, which is again why I found memorizing the formula isn't really that helpful, because you know, you could say, well, I start at C and then I go from C to D and then I go from D to E and I end up at E. So it kind of makes sense. So in this R to B, B to A thing, we would basically use the same picture that we had up here, except R, so this would be, as it's pictured, this would be R from A to B, right? But if I took this and I drew it the opposite direction, I hate to mess it up, it's so pretty. Ah, well, so I'll just kind of sketch it over here. So I could say that I could go to A, well, I could, here's B. So I could say that I go to B, and then I go from B to A, and then I end up at A. So this would be R from B to A. Put these down here. Put this down here next to our picture. Okay. So when we say R from B to A, we're basically saying it's R from A to B, except the other direction. Okay. So again, don't get too caught up in everything, but know that the general convention is that we start here, and that's where we end. So that's the head, I suppose, and that's the... I guess it depends on what you call head and tail. I like to use start and finish. This is where we start, and this is where we finish. And usually if you see the letter by itself, that means you're starting from the origin.